Which video editing software do you use? Premiere Pro or DaVinci Resolve? Or maybe some other? Let me know in the comments. In this video, I will compare Adobe's solution with DaVinci Resolve. One of the biggest advantages of DaVinci Resolve is that it is all-in-one solution. It combines editing, color correction, visual effects, motion graphics, and audio post-production all in one software tool. With Adobe software, you need Premiere Pro for editing, After Effects for advanced graphics, Adobe Audition for audio, and Media Encoder to export the video. Even though Premiere Pro has an option called Dynamic Link, which allows us to edit the clips or audio in After Effects or Audition when they are still open in Premiere Pro, many artists have issues with it due to its buggy nature. On the other hand, it is handy if you work within Adobe ecosystem. For example, you use motion graphics from Illustrator and you want to animate them in After Effects. In Arvis, I think there is no need for that though, and I very much prefer to have everything in one software. As artists, we spend quite a lot on software, and pricing is the important thing for most of us. What is great about DaVinci is they have a one-time fee. You spend $295 and can use the software how long you want. On top of that, they have a free version too, which has about 90% of the features, so it might even be enough for your type of work. Also, if you buy the Blackmagic camera or accessory, you get the DaVinci paid version as a bonus. The cheapest editing panel costs around $395, so you add only $100 to the software price. Adobe, on the other hand, works on subscription basis. They offer a free trial, but it's available only for 7 days. You can buy the software separately or in packs to save some money. As an example, Premiere Pro costs $23 per month for individuals, while the All Apps plan costs $60 per month, also for individuals. You will need at least Premiere Pro, After Effects, and Photoshop, so it's best to go with All Apps option, which will cost you $720 just for the first year. If you use DaVinci, you will have to pay only for Photoshop, which costs $10 a month with a yearly subscription. To sum up, in the short run, and especially in the long run, DaVinci is way cheaper or even free if you choose this version. After you pay once for DaVinci, your yearly costs for Photoshop will be just $120 versus $720 for the whole Creative Cloud, which is 6 times the difference. Another important point for us is the performance. DaVinci is considered more stable, it can handle complex projects efficiently. DaVinci is faster and it has smoother interface, especially if you have lower-end machines, you'll see the difference. If you click on something in DaVinci, it does it very quickly and there is no major lag. It's because all the pages edit the same timeline, making the workflow smooth even for heavy editing tasks. For Adobe, you need a powerful computer. Otherwise, it becomes very laggy and the workflow is extremely inefficient. In Premiere Pro, it sometimes takes a while to process some actions. It can make a huge difference in the time you spend on editing. Adobe is known for crashing, which sometimes can be a nightmare. To avoid losing your work, you need to turn on the Autosave. You can set it, for instance, every 5 minutes, but it also interrupts the work. DaVinci, on the other hand, saves every move in the background. So when it crashes, the worst case scenario is that you lose just one action. For me, it's a game changer. In Premiere Pro, everything is all over the place. If you want to have many panels turned on, there isn't too much working place left for a video preview, for instance. On another hand, it's a truly customized program. You can adjust it to your needs however you want. You can use their presets to arrange their panels, or just click and drag them wherever you want. Want to move this panel to another place? Not a problem, just toggle it off and move it wherever you need. You can even unlock them and have them appear on another screen. DaVinci, on the other hand, is not customizable. You cannot modify the interface. You can only toggle panel off and on, and you cannot move them around. But it has a thoughtfully designed interface, where everything goes left to right. It squeezes various editing tasks into dedicated panels. We have a cut page for fast editing, an edit page for in-depth editing, a fusion page for visual effects and motion graphics, color for color correction and grading, and fairlight for audio editing. To access all these pages, we only have to click any of them. At the end, we have a delivery page where we export the files. It really makes sense, but I have to admit that because I was used to Adobe environment, it was a bit overwhelming at first. However, as soon as I understood the workflow, I fell in love with this system. It didn't take me long to get used to that. So to sum up, if you need a software that is fully customizable, then Premiere Pro is a better choice. However, from what I know, not many artists change the interface of the software they use. So for that reason, DaVinci in general is a better choice, as it's less confusing. If you want to improve as an artist, secure a job, and be perceived as an expert in the field, boosting your skills is the best option. With more than 80 lessons from our new animation training, you will learn everything you need to know about commercial architectural animations. We structured the course in 10 modules to support you with the most effective learning. We explain how we created the animation step by step, so you will be able to create your video afterward. Check on the details on the website. The link will be in the corner and in the description below the video. DaVinci Resolve is Hollywood's most advanced color corrector, and it stands out in color grading compared to other programs because it started as a professional color grading software and they turned into editing software. It makes it a top choice for professional colorists. It's a different system we are typically used to, as it uses nodes. You might be overwhelmed when your timeline disappears and you suddenly see these nodes, but as you get it, it's all pretty straightforward. Premiere Pro is easier in that terms, especially if you used any other Adobe software before. Even though Premiere Pro offers an extensive collection of effects and transitions and integrates well with After Effects for more complex visual work, DaVinci still is the king of color grading. For me, DaVinci is way better for quick edits. It's simply faster and more enjoyable. It's user-friendly, and because of this, we can speed up the workflow a lot. For example, fading is extremely easy. We just have to click here and move this to the right. In Premiere Pro, we have to add the film resolve first, and then we can adjust it. Or we can animate opacity. Anyway, compared to DaVinci, it looks like a workaround. Also in DaVinci, I love this toolbar on the edit page. For instance, this one. I use it to find the best part of the stock footage in our animation. Pretty handy option. There is one more thing I should mention here. Premiere Pro is saved in PROJ format. That means it's saved as another file. For example, Max for 3ds Max, PSD for Photoshop, and so on. DaVinci, on another hand, has its own database. We don't save the files the standard way, where we can choose a location and open it later on from a file. Here we have everything inside the software. You can choose where the database will be located though. At first, it's kind of weird, but with time, when you get used to that, it becomes very comfortable. One major advantage of Premiere Pro is Media Encoder, a program that Adobe requires you to install whenever you install Premiere Pro. You can send all your exports there, and because it's a separate program, you can continue editing in Premiere Pro while your videos are being exported. On the other hand, if you queue up videos to render and export in DaVinci, you're unable to do anything else in DaVinci until the rendering process is finished. This is a bit annoying. If you want to work efficiently, you have to plan your exports so it doesn't hold up your work. Taking into consideration the stability of the software, the workflow speed, and the color corrector, I decided to switch from Premiere Pro to DaVinci Resolve. Also, the pricing was something that helped me in the final decision. I don't regret it, and I can recommend DaVinci for CG artists. If you want to learn all about architectural animations, join our training. If you want to watch more videos like this one, stay here on YouTube. Bye-bye!